Good afternoon, Pastor.
How you doing, John?
As you guys see, we're in a different location. Want to welcome those to Random Moments and Unfiltered with Pastor David. And Pastor, I want to speak a little bit more about the vaccine. It seems that as the vaccine has been surrounding the church in quite a number of different ways. And I came across an article today and wanted your feedback on it, where pastors are now requiring their attendees to get the vaccine in order for them to come to church. And I wanted your feedback on that.
Well, we haven't done that. I think that I've got a lot of opinions on that. I'm trying to figure one that would fit into our narrative at the moment. I still believe that I have the right to make a determination personally as to whether or not I feel comfortable receiving a vaccine. That's the first thing. And my wife and I would be in agreement with this kind of thing, that adults should make their decisions for their own body with the help of their physician, if you will, and taking everything into consideration. So that's a personal choice. And I don't feel that I, as a pastor, have the responsibility to foist my requirements on people based on what I think is best for their life. I'm not a scientist, and therefore I have to be careful not to impose on people what I'm hearing and sure is real and true. And so we haven't done that in our church. We do still have a section for those who feel comfortable using masks, of course. Why is that? It's because there are some who've been told by maybe a doctor, maybe a health provider, or even a husband or wife, that they feel comfortable, for whatever the reason may be, they feel more comfortable with that person wearing a mask than not wearing a mask. And I have to abide by their own conscience. I have to abide by that. So on one level, in our church, there's no requirement for you to wear a mask. I haven't seen the reasonableness of that for some time. I, like every other American, have been not so much confused by, but become tired by the conflicting opinions that can come out of the same mouth in the course of a week or two. You know, we have a Dr. Fauci saying, no, you don't need to wear masks. Then you say, well, it would be best to wear masks. Then you hear him saying, now you need to wear two masks. And he's not the only one doing that. And so from my perspective, you have to just make decisions based on what you feel is best for yourself, because you can't rely on those who've been hired by the government to give their own propaganda. I do know that young people are being told you need to have a mandatory vaccination in order to attend classes. And yet at the same time, we're being told that the young people are not even being affected by this virus. You know, and then they're saying, we want to vaccinate children as young as 6 and even younger than that. And then others are saying that's harmful for their systems. You know, have a COVID, anti-COVID vaccine, and then you're getting enlargement of hearts, and people 18, 19, and 20 are being affected, to some even dying. And so this is a conflicting thing. So I, as a pastor, I'm no medical practitioner. I most certainly have no experience in that field. So I have to basically get as much information as I can, put it together, and make a decision for the best of my church. And so as a pastor, I'm not afraid. I wasn't afraid before. And my wife and I had COVID, even as you and your family and all. We had it. We survived it. Thank God. I bless the Lord for it. We still have lingering effects of it. My wife and I both are still kind of like fogged memory-wise because of it. You know, but you know what? We're here, we're doing our ministry and all, and so getting back to the main question, if people come to my church, I don't think that the preaching of the gospel of the inoculation or the vaccine is what I've been called to do. I say come to church. You know, here in California, it's borderline crazy in some ways, where you have politicians who are making money peddling fear. That's what it is. I don't understand, for example, how you can reopen Dodger Stadium with 50, 60,000 people and then, well, no, you shouldn't, you really shouldn't congregate in church. So you can get 60,000 people into an arena, but be careful when you go into a restaurant. It makes no sense. You can stand in line in an airport. You have to be 6 feet apart, and then you're placed next to a stranger, shoulder to shoulder, and he takes his mask off as he's eating and drinking and doesn't put it back on. John, it's just, it's a farce in many ways. I think people are aware of it. I'm not a sheep in that way. I'm a sheep for Jesus, but I'm not a sheep for science. And so even though Fauci claims to be the incarnation of science itself, to argue against what he says is to argue against science, as if he has incarnated, he's the personification of all the wise men who've ever lived. That's a confusion. And so in my church, I want people to come back. I want them to come home. It's a safe environment. We do the best we can to secure those who are concerned. We don't make people feel bad because they wear masks. They should come home. They should come to church. That's how we're looking at it.
And come to church where the gospel's preached. Well, nothing's peddled. Well, actually, this Sunday is you're starting a new book.
I'm starting the Gospel of Mark, and doing the first 8 verses. And one of the things that stands out, I'll say it quickly because I know I'm going to lose people that are going to stop watching. But John the Baptist, he dressed in a certain way and he had a certain message, and so he personified the message he gave. He was a humble man. He taught a message of humility. He was a man aware of who he was, and he taught a message of repentance and rightness with God. And would God more pastors would actually live out the message that they preach. Amen. And we'll be looking at that this
Sunday. And that's the message that needs to be pushed in our nation today.
I would think it's called the gospel. You know, I go to church not to hear about who I should vote for. Right. You know, I go to church not to hear the latest news that somebody got from some friend of a friend of a friend who's a doctor. I go to church so I can know how to live for Jesus Christ. Amen. I think that's why you go to church, or should. And that's what we're trying to do in our fellowship, is just teach about Jesus and let people use their own common sense and seek God in prayer and His Word.
Amen. Well, you guys, thank you so much for tuning in. Pastor, thank you so much.
Of course.
Church starts at 8:30 a.m. Sunday morning, 10:45. We also have our Israel trip in March.
Israel's coming up.
And so you guys go on our website and register. It will change your life.
Come with us.
Yes. And we'll also change lives if you come on Sunday morning.
It can change your life.
It'll change lives. So come on out and join us. And again, Pastor, thank you so much for your time.
All right.
God bless you guys.
Thank you.